What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Nate Biggs. You already know what it is. Today, I'm going to touch on nature, you know. What I mean by that is everything around us is based off of nature. So we have to observe nature and observe our natures and observe others' natures to understand what it truly is and what the isness of that being or thing is, right? So basically, as is stated, with us human beings, when we communicate, a lot of people need to understand this fact. It's not what you say, but it's what you do, right? You observe something by their nature on how they act and how they respond or react to things and certain stimuli, right? Not what they say, you know? Some people can tell you one thing and then do the opposite. But truth be told, you judge something based on how and what it does, not what it tells you it perceives it is doing, right? So in nature, it's the same thing. You look at animals, right? Right, you look at a lion, you look at a tiger, you look at a bear. At the end of the day, when it's out in the wild in nature, the way it survives and it preserves itself is based upon what it is and its function, right? But sometimes you'll see people take animals to a zoo. They'll train that animal, like a lion, a tiger, whatever, to, you know, perform certain tricks and be soft. But truth be told, that lion and tiger is still an animal. It's still a lion or a tiger because its nature dictates its genetic mainframe on what it is by how it acts and how it self-preserves itself. It's the same thing with us human beings, right? When you see, you know what I mean, how we communicate with each other, we have to have a better understanding of our natures so we can respect each other's natures, so we can respond to each other based on how we act. And then accordingly, that's how we should treat each other, based on that accountability of our nature. So we're not fooled, you know? So we are on a spectrum of respecting ourselves as well as respecting others, or learning how, if we can't get along with someone, we identify their nature ahead of time. What happens is sometimes we project our nature onto others without actually observing and respecting their nature and treating them accordingly. And that's where chaos and conflict occurs, because we no longer are viewing things by their nature. We're doing and viewing things by how we perceive them for wanting them to be. And in a way, that's a way of trying to exert our control on it, other beings, is because we are wanting them to adjust and be how we perceive them to be on our nature, which is called projection. Which, even though we might say, you know, it's, you know, we want the best for others, right? But truth be told, others should want the best for themselves. Right. And we should treat others based on how they want to be treated, not how we think they want to be treated, by observing their nature and listening and communicating by exactly what they say and what they do. And if what they say and what they do goes with each other, right, in satisfactory conditions, then that means that that's who and what that person is. But if they tell you one thing and do the opposite, then you can come to a conclusion that their nature of what they're doing does not fit their perception of how they view themselves, and we accordingly treat them based on how they act, right? And we respect ourselves in that light. And more or less, we have to observe our nature even further so we know ourselves. And that's what Know Thyself is really more or less about. It's about knowing your nature and how you correspond with others in their nature. Right? Following these metaphysical principles is all based on nature, natural law. It's all based on the first law of self-preservation and the laws that govern how things correspond, how things vibrate, right? The mentalism of the landscape and space that we exist in, of observation of things outside of ourselves to how we feel inside of ourselves, right? Knowing who and what we are through our gender, right? Knowing the different attributes and traits of each gender and what those attributes and traits possess, and skillfully analyzing our potential, knowing that whatever we put our mind to, we can basically achieve, even if it be negative or positive. These are observing the laws of nature, right? And to help others motivate themselves is teaching them they need to be aware of their nature as well. They need to be aware of their God's gift that's given to them, you know? So everything in nature is about respect. And that's my opinion. And more or less, when I say respect, I mean that the fact of not trying to force others to adapt to our circumstances, but to respect the circumstances that we both are in and coming to a consensus that we must have that respect of each other's free will for our natures to be at a higher level so we can expand our quality of life, right? And that's the key to this. It's an ongoing process of becoming our greatest version. And the only way to start to become our greatest version is to identify and know our nature, right? And know that we have the ability to be our greatest version. Look at the evidence of archaeology of the greatest times past of civilization. It's still around in stone today, right? The Great Pyramids, for example, all over the planet. You see that humanity had the nature to work together and advance itself. But at the same time, our natures of our egos negatively affected us to fall, right? The fall of humanity. And now we're rising again. And the only way to rise together is to rise together with respect. And the division you're seeing in this world today is because people are trying to project their beliefs onto others without having respect of each other's opinions. So the key to our world advancing to a utopia, I feel, is respecting each other's natures. Knowing that if we can't get along, then we shouldn't go along, right? But if we can get along, then we can still go along. At the end of the day, respect is the key in the totality of the natural law. And respecting ourselves is the totality of becoming our greatest version of ourselves. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, and all my people out there, one love. So all is one, all is well. Catch you on the next ride. Respect the nature of others as they respect you. Peace and love. Take care.